Berks Community Action Program on BCTV is supported by the Berks Community Action Program.
Okay. Good morning. I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. My name is Jodi Readinger. I'm BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live on today, Tuesday, June 5th, here in the BCTV studios. I have a guest with me today who I'm thrilled to introduce. It's kind of a bittersweet guest because we're celebrating her achievements, but also announcing her retirement. So without further ado, with me is Debbie Strunk, who is BCAP's housing case manager, mortgage default counselor. We could probably fill up a whole page. Deb has been with the agency since 1989, so that makes almost 29 years?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. And she has worked primarily out of our Budget Counseling Center with a number of different projects. We were very pleased a couple weeks ago at our Community Action Month luncheon to honor her with our William F. Richardson Award. This is an award that's given each year to a deserving member of the community who looks at community action and helping people in need as a vocation, a calling rather than a job, going above and beyond what their paycheck says and what their hours of service are to the agency. And Deb has certainly done that over her years with the agency. So we're going to hear a little bit more about her career and her future plans, and hopefully some good stories about her time at BCAP. So, Deb, we talked a little bit before we got started. Your last position at BCAP, what were you doing when you decided to retire?
I didn't actually decide to retire. It was more like the powers that be gave me the retirement plan because I ended up sick with cancer, but I'm doing better now.
Well,
so I was doing the mortgage assistance program through the court system.
Which is something that's fairly unique to BCAP and something we developed with, I'm thinking the Bar Association and lenders and things like that?
The Bar Association, lenders, and lenders' attorneys were involved. What I would do is meet with clients and put together a packet of information for the lender, the clients. Some clients were 4 months behind in their mortgage. Some clients were a lot more, like 9 months to a year behind in their mortgage. They came in, they applied, we had to do a budget of all their income, all their expenses. They needed to write a paragraph of what happened, why they fell behind, so far behind in their mortgage. And then the mortgage company would look at everything and make a decision of if they were going to help them with a new mortgage. And a lot of people did get approved, and they were able to save their homes. And that program is still running today. Juana from the Budget Counseling Center is now running that program.
Sounds very interesting. Sounds like a lot of hard work, a lot of intensive paperwork. I know there's days. I'm surprised we didn't just open your office door and not be able to find you for all the paper that you shuffled with your different loan applications and things like that. But everything was very intensive. But it sounds very rewarding when you can actually help somebody save their house.
Yeah, it's very rewarding. I've gotten thank you cards, and one gentleman sent me a picture of his home after he got approved for his mortgage assistance, so, and beautiful home, and I was really happy that he was able to save his home.
Oh, that's great. So, in addition to the mortgage diversion, I know you've done a couple different things since I've been with the agency. So what kind of programs have you been a part of? What kind of things, you know, was there a favorite one? I know you were doing the Homeowners Emergency Mortgage Assistance Program, and that kind of morphed into this thing with the lenders, or is that still going on?
That program is still running today. We're the only state that actually has that, and it's kind of a seems like a secret program. A lot of people do not know about it until you actually fall behind on your mortgage. But when you're 30 to 60 days behind on your mortgage, you'll receive a letter from your mortgage company stating that you could apply for this program. They give you the name of housing counseling agencies that deal with the program, and you call and speak with a counselor, and an appointment will be set up, and they will tell you all the things you will need for the appointment, and you just bring them with, and the counselors are very educated and very well versed on how to do all of that, and they will then send the packet into Pennsylvania Housing Finance Agency, who makes the decision, and they can help bring your mortgage current, or they can also give you ongoing assistance.
Sounds like a great program. And you mentioned something, that the counselors are very knowledgeable, and that's one thing, you know, when I started at BCAP a couple years after you, we were in different locations. So on a day-to-day basis, we didn't interact very much. But I always knew that if I had a question about a mortgage, if I had a question about a reverse mortgage or something, I could call Deb, and she would fill me in. So definitely, as with every staff person at BCAP, she's an expert in her field. And was always willing to share that information and help out with things like that. You had talked about a budgeting program that you'd done in conjunction with the Housing Authority. So you've kind of done a little bit of everything at the Budget Counseling Center. You've done budgeting, some pre-purchase counseling also?
Yes, the pre-purchase counseling. Years ago, we did a pre-purchase counseling. We haven't done that in a while, though. But what we would do is go over the closing costs for anyone purchasing the home, go over their closing costs sheet and explain all the different variables that's going to happen at closing that would make the client much more at ease once they went in to doing the closing of purchasing their home.
Okay. I know that's very helpful, and I've sent lots of people over there for that, because the whole closing process and buying a house can be very confusing. And sometimes it's nice to have someone who doesn't have a stake in it, you're not a realtor that's getting a commission or something else to kind of walk you through those steps. And we're very proud about people who actually can buy their first home. So you started at BCAP in 1989.
Yes.
How did you end up? A lot of people have interesting stories about how they ended up at BCAP. Was there a position you applied for, or?
I applied for housing.
Okay.
Housing counselor. Yes, I know a lot of people that came into our office stepped up from basically the receptionist and then became counselors. But I had sold real estate and sold homes. But I was a single mom, and I wanted to have something that had security and had health insurance with two children to raise. And also I would have my weekends to myself. So that is the main reason I decided to look for something more substantial that I could count on.
And, you know, so many of us that have been at BCAP for lots of years, we've definitely grown with our positions. And I tease a lot that, you know, there's not many employers that you go to them and say, well, I want to do this. I want to add this onto my duties. They don't say no. We sometimes think at BCAP that our plates, instead of being like regular dinner size, we have these huge turkey platters, or some days I think I have the steam table, because there's so much need out there and there's so much we want to do. So while BCAP has been a huge part of your life for the last 28 years, there's also other stuff you've done besides that out in the community. I know you volunteered with BCTV.
Yes, for many years. We helped do dance party. William and I both helped to do dance party, and we did the cameras there. And we would come in usually once a week and help on the cameras with a few of the different shows.
Okay. And I think once or twice you did a BCAP show at night when we were there, when we still had an evening show. Caught you behind the camera. What other volunteer work or outside activities have you been interested in?
Well, motorcycles. We used to ride a lot of do a lot of riding on the motorcycles, and we do Daytona twice a year to the bike events down there. So,
what happens in Daytona stays in Daytona.
I guess so.
I know Facebook allows us to see other sides of our coworkers that we wouldn't have known about otherwise. But I know you've traveled a lot, and you have a lot of musical friends also.
I knew you were going to bring that.
No, and you've, yes, you know, you've shared stories with us, and you've helped us get music for different events that we've done locally and things like that. So you've had a lot of interest outside of BCAP. Working in an agency in such close contact with people, and, you know, do you have a specific memory of one client or one family that just, you know, either brings a tear to your eye or makes you smile?
There's just so many. I can't say just one. I do remember one client that I helped to. We used to just do budget counseling alone, and I helped him prepare his budget, and he came back after a few years and spoke to the receptionist and said that he followed the budget, and by following the budget, he was able to purchase a home. So that makes me proud and happy for him. So it's great if someone comes back and has been able to do something with the budget that you've planned for them, and able to go on with their lives and better themselves. That's a great feeling.
And that's great when people come back and say thank you and say you've helped us. And
yes.
It's you spend so much time sometimes on a short, you know, in a week or a month or on somebody's case, and then, you know, they get approved and they move on with their life, and you know, don't know what happens. So it's always nice to, you know, catch up or run into people at Walmart or the grocery store.
Yes. That does happen.
It's definitely does. The William F. Richardson Award. We talked a little bit about that. William F. Richardson was BCAP's executive director for 20 plus years. He started in 1979, retired in the 90s. So I guess it was a little bit over 20 years. He brought so many of us on board that are still here, and was just an inspiration to so many staff and board members and people in the community. He's still with us. This isn't a eulogy. But everybody has a Bill story. But the William F. Richardson Award is in his spirit, because he just had such a heart for what we do at BCAP. And while there are hundreds of agencies like us across the country, I don't think in Berks County, in Pennsylvania, or in the United States, there's one that has as much heart as we do, that has the people that just, you know, care so much and go that extra mile. Debbie, I know that you could have just, you know, done your packets in a couple hours and been done with it, but you've spent so much time with your people, explaining them and coaching them, and just, Bill instilled in all of us just a caring and a great atmosphere that continues over to this day. And I know, as I encounter sometimes people in other agencies, that heart isn't always there. So do you have a favorite Bill Richardson story or a Bill Richardson memory?
Not really a favorite story. Bill Richardson was in the other office from our office. Our office was at that time on 5th Street, and we always called the office. He was in the main office, but so I basically only interacted with him at office meetings, and then when we would have specials like luncheons and our Christmas parties. But he always made the parties very enjoyable. He would always, we'd sing songs at Christmas songs, and we would, a lot of times he would write a poem and write a information about BCAP and about what we were doing, and he just always made everything so enjoyable. It was really great to have him as a leader in our office.
And you brought up the when you started, it was the main office and you know, the budget center and the weatherization office. And we've just finally in the past 2 years come together. We're all in the same spot in our Penn Street offices. But you're right, we didn't interact much. And you dealt mostly with George Miller, who was your director.
Yes.
And I have to say, there's a lot of stuff that went on at the Budget Center, a lot of good stuff that went on at the Budget Center that I didn't realize till I would be out in the community and somebody would say, oh, you know, this happened to me at the Budget Center, or they did this for me at the Budget Center. So do you have a George story?
Do I have a George story?
I put her on the spot here.
Yes, she sure did. No, not really. I mean, he would like to do a lot of jokes, though. there were times when the weatherization came over into our office, and they were over on the second floor. And him and Mike Mike from weatherization would do things, and every now and then they pull little jokes on everybody. So,
yes.
That's what I remember from George.
I remember a famous picture with everybody holding up a George face in front of them.
Yes, that was a George face, yes.
But definitely a lot of stuff went on, a lot of good work, a lot of fun. So what's next for you?
I don't know yet. That hasn't been given to me. I think the powers that be... I have something planned for me, really. But right now, we're going to enjoy myself, and we're going to take a road trip.
Oh, is cool.
Next in my agenda. We're going to leave the end of June and take a road trip out.
Oh, that sounds exciting.
Yeah, Las Vegas and New Mexico to... Roswell, if anybody's familiar with Roswell, that's where the aliens supposedly landed, 1947. So we're going out there to check that out.
Oh, that sounds great. And my experience with people who've retired from BCAP, there's been a couple, is they're retired for a couple months and then they're doing something and then you run into them again doing something else, different agency, different. So you don't, when you're in a business and you've been so committed to helping people for so long, it's hard to kind of stop.
Yeah.
And I know you have always gone that extra mile, and that has been so incredibly important. But a road trip sounds really cool. Okay. So what advice would you give to people that starting their career, going into human services, or what's your biggest takeaway from BCAP? What's the biggest thing you learned?
Well, you need to care about your clients. It's not just paper pushing. It's finding out exactly what's happening. You know, if they fell behind in the mortgage, what caused it? Was it illness, divorce, separation? I mean, there's many reasons why people end up falling behind. Mortgage increased to an unaffordable amount. I mean, so you need to care about your clients and listen to what they have to say to find out exactly what the problem is. And get as much education as you can. Go to as many seminars as you can. There's a lot of good information out there with different seminars, and you learn a lot from other counselors at the seminars also.
Yes, yeah, definitely that, you know, learning what differences there are in different communities, and Berks County is different from Montgomery County, which is different from Lancaster County. But definitely, I like that learning and caring and learning the story behind, mm-hmm. Taking the time to really listen. I in a situation now, my part-time job, I work with some men who are deaf. So you really, I found myself having to focus on communicating with them because you can't have your back to them. You mm-hmm. can't, you have to look at them. And it's made me refocus a little bit sometimes how I communicate with people, you know, with everybody. That's, it's, you know, you have to refocus. So we're always learning. We're always learning new things. Okay. So, it's so hard to sum up everything you've done for BCAP in a half an hour TV show. What am I forgetting?
Oh, goodness. Reverse mortgages. I love doing those. I did those for many, many years when they first started to came out. Betty Hillard and I both did the reverse mortgage counseling, and it's still out there and still going strong, but our office doesn't do the counseling any longer. But it is a good program for seniors that needed the extra help. I mean, I remember one couple that they were coming in just so they would have extra money to do things they wanted to do. If they wanted to do, go to a restaurant with their friends or go out to a movie, they really didn't have the extra money for that, and the reverse mortgage was going to allow them to do that. So it was a great program. They get to stay in their home, keep their home, and have extra money to do the things they wanted to do.
Okay. And I know we've talked about reverse mortgages a number of times because people bring that up as a solution. And, you know, every time Tom Selleck or Alex Trebek is on TV talking about them, we get a call or two about it.
Really?
And, you know, I know it's a very long and detailed process. And there's a lot of approvals to it and things like that. But I have called Debbie as the expert sometimes and said, okay, somebody asked me about this and I don't know. Would that have been your favorite program? Was it, what else made an impact on you? I know the budget counseling, the one-on-one stuff. I know at one point you were doing that, Luz was doing that, and it was incredibly intense. You would, you know, work with people on a regular basis for months and mm-hmm. months and months, just to get them on track.
I wouldn't say there's just one favorite program. I enjoy doing more than one program because different programs have different aspects, and it kept you moving in your job where you would do different things for different people. So it was nice to have a variety of different things to do.
There was never a normal day, was there?
No.
And I know there were times that your calendar was quite booked.
Yes.
But it's been an adventure.
Yes, BCAP has been an adventure. So.
Oh, well, that's great. Debbie, you know, on behalf of everybody at BCAP and all the people that you've helped throughout the years, thank you so much, because I know you have gone that extra mile.
Yes.
Maybe we should change the name to BCAP to Extra Mile, because everybody there has been so inspiring. So, Debbie, I'd like to thank you for joining me today. Congratulations so much on your award.
Thank you.
Enjoy your road trip. Don't think about us at all. BCTV for hosting us. Everybody out there watching. And for everybody at BCAP, where we believe a neighbor in need is a call to action.
Berks Community Action Program on BCTV is supported by the Berks Community Action Program.